This video is sponsored by Banzoogle. Well, hey there, everybody. How are you doing today? We are hanging out outside. It was super nice out, and I thought, why not shoot this video out here while it's not crazy windy? And I want to talk about five things that I feel like the modern musician really needs nowadays. You know, it's quite different for musicians now than it was 20 years ago. So I feel like it's a little bit different than just kind of sit in your room, practice guitar all day, and, you know, get in a band and tour around. You know, it's not that you can do that, but it's not the only outlet that you have now. So we might as well kind of utilize and take advantage of all the stuff that we have going on for us. So numero uno is social media. You kind of need to be in social media nowadays. You know, I love social media just because I love that connection with you guys more than anything. Getting to actually respond to people, talk, you know, all that kind of stuff. And getting feedback is the most important thing. And learning like what you guys like, what you dislike, it's extremely helpful. It's the best kind of like information you can get is directly from the people who, you know, watch your content. Even if you want to approach it from more of, I guess, like a business standpoint, I think it actually makes you more valuable as an asset if you're trying to get like a touring gig or something like that. Like if you have a huge online following of hundreds of thousands of people and this person wants to hire you to go on tour with them, well, you're gonna look a little bit more appealing because they're like, oh, well, they have a huge audience, you know, just on their own. So they're gonna be pulling those people in as well. So, I think social media is super important. Learn how it works, read up on it. I do social media for a bunch of different brands and companies and stuff like that. It's very, very vital and crucial. So definitely look into social media and don't be afraid to read some paragraphs and stories and reports on what kind of works and what doesn't work. Number two is you need to spend some time understanding your audience and what exactly it is that you are most passionate about. So this one I think is very, very crucial because obviously like nowadays djent music is very popular. And even though I've done a few djent videos, they were just kind of more like spoof kind of videos, making fun of not only myself, but I like to make fun of all genres of music, actually, because I think music is equally amazing, and it's kind of a funny thing when you really look at it. But I think understanding your audience is very, very crucial. So for me, I know what I'm most passionate about. It's rock music, you know, maybe a little bit into metal, stuff like that. So I really tie into that. You don't see me doing a lot of jazz videos or, you know, actually teaching people how to djent or something like that. Because I know that's not my strong suit. That's not really an asset that I have. So I know that I'm gonna make better content because it's what I actually like to play and it's what I'm passionate about. So I think that it's really important not just to kind of like feed in completely to what's popular. There's nothing wrong with like taking on what's popular. Like I did a video, djent riffs versus dad riffs. So obviously the dad rock or just rock and roll is something that I'm, you know, much more familiar with and more passionate about than djent stuff. But, you know, I was still kind of like, I'm like, okay, it's popular. I'm not ignoring that this, you know, genre exists, but it's like, okay, how can we kind of tie it into what you do? So I think just understanding your audience is super, super important. And number three is, of course, having a website, which you might not believe it, but a lot of companies, if you want to plan on working with different brands and stuff like that, they require you to send them an official website link. They want to know that you actually have a website, and I think it's very crucial. And thankfully, the guys at Banzoogle did sponsor today's video. So like I've mentioned before in other videos that they've sponsored, I was using Banzoogle way before any of this stuff. I've been using it for about 3 years now, and it's how I sell all my lesson packs. They have thousands of different layouts that you can choose from. You can literally design your website in just a few minutes. You can sell your merch. There's different plans you can go through. There's mailing lists. It's all like mobile friendly. Like the stuff actually looks good on mobile. A lot of websites have a hard time with that. It'll look really good on desktop and not so good on mobile. And especially with mobile stuff being so crucial nowadays, because you know most new media and stuff is consumed through mobile devices like phones or tablets and stuff like that, you really need it to look good on mobile devices. And the final thing is they have plans starting at as little as $8.29 a month, and with the promo code RBGuitar, you can save 15% for your first year. Now that is a dang diggity dog deal. I'm just gonna throw it out there. And number four, And I think that is, you know, learning what you need to record. You know, if you're a musician, odds are you play music, would make sense. And you're gonna need to record. So you're gonna need to know the gear that you need, You know, you don't necessarily need all of this, like MacBooks and all these kind of things like that. You can get by with a very basic PC. I mean, nowadays you can record on your phone. I think IK Multimedia has all kinds of stuff that you can use on just your phone. So you really need to know what you need to record, what's going to work for you, and what's going to be the most effective, whether it's maybe you're a person who wants to record with real amps, you need a mic, or maybe you need like load boxes or something like that, like Two Note stuff. Lots and lots of options out there. So you really just need to figure out what you need. If it's, you know, needs to be super budget friendly, look at plugins. You know, then you just need literally like a super inexpensive kind of interface, and you can use plugins. There's all kinds of cool, just different things that you can do. So I highly recommend really like figuring out what you need. And if you don't know at all, like I know I didn't know for the longest time, and I asked my buddy Rusty, I was like, what do I need to record? And he kind of pointed me in the right direction and got me started a very, you know, very basic setup, but it got me going, and then I kind of learned what I needed along the way. And number five, high five, is have your own creative space. I think that this is super crucial and very important. Now, I know that everyone doesn't always have the luxury of having a room that they can dedicate to themselves, but if there's even a corner, anything like that that you can have that is just yours, it's your space for recording, writing, you can make it a creative environment wherever you are. And I think it's so crucial because you don't want to be, you know, cramped in someone else's area trying to do your own thing. So if there's any way, I mean, it could be outside. Maybe you need to, you know, work out on the porch or something like that. But just anything to have your own space where you have a home location, you know, that I know for me, having like a room that I have all my recording stuff in has always been crucial because it instantly makes me feel more creative. I'm like, that's kind of the vibe that this room puts off. So as soon as I get in there, I kind of get in that creative mindset, and I think it really, really helps me out a lot. So I definitely say, if it's at all possible, have a creative, whether it's a home studio, whether it's a guitar room, whether it's a closet, whatever you have to do, but just have a space that is set aside for you. And wow, that is a loud bird. Alrighty, homies, that is it. Hope you enjoyed this little video. Thank you again to the guys over at Bandzoogle for sponsoring this. I really, really appreciate them supporting the channel like that. And as always, hope you guys don't mind these sponsored videos. I'm pretty picky with the companies that I allow to do this. And, you know, a company like Bandzoogle, who I've used for a long time, I have no issues with them wanting to sponsor stuff. So don't forget, you can save yourself 15% with the promo code RBGuitar. And until next time, homies, I'll be seeing you on Mondizzle. And let's hope this nice weather continues. So I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Rock on.